Nattokinase is an enzyme that's found in natto, a fermented food that's been used by Asian countries for over 2,000 years. And because several clinical trials have hinted that nattokinase can lower cholesterol and blood pressure and may even be a natural clot buster, it's been put forth as a potential natural therapy for heart disease. But is that really true? For everyone who's been asking me to review nattokinase, this one's for you. By the way, if you're here for the very first time, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and share this review with your friends. This is an unbiased review. I don't work for any supplement company or pharmaceutical company either. Basically, I analyze the research so you don't have to. Okay, so let's look at the proof for nattokinase. And let's begin with this study showing that even a single dose of nattokinase improved markers of blood clot breakdown by 44% in just 6 hours after taking the supplement. In the study, researchers were testing the effects of nattokinase in young, healthy men in their 20s, which may or may not reflect how well nattokinase works in people who are older and not so healthy. Next up is this clinical trial. This is a randomized clinical trial on the ability of nattokinase to prevent blood clots. This is a larger clinical trial. It involves 265 men and women. They're in their 60s, and they're given either nattokinase at a dosage of 2,000 FU or a placebo, and they're followed for 3 years. Now, I know what you're thinking. What the heck is FU? And no, it doesn't mean what you think. FU means fibrinolytic units, and it's a very common measure in the world of nattokinase research, where FU is a reference to how potent the nattokinase enzyme is. Now, good rule of thumb to remember if you go looking for nattokinase supplements, 100 milligrams of nattokinase is equal to about 2,000 fibrinolytic units. Now, back to the study. So these people, I want to point out, they didn't have high blood pressure, they didn't have diabetes or kidney problems, and they weren't taking blood thinners either. In other words, these people were not seriously sick. Okay, so what happened? So it's reported that nattokinase failed to improve carotid artery stiffness or thickness of the carotid artery either. Additionally, nattokinase failed to reduce cholesterol levels, LDL, triglycerides, blood sugar, or any other parameter that was measured in the blood in this study. In short, nattokinase didn't do anything. Next up is this randomized clinical trial where they looked at whether nattokinase could lower blood pressure. In this 8-week clinical trial, 73 men and women with high blood pressure or elevated blood pressure, but who were not taking blood pressure medications, were given 2,000 fibrinolytic units of nattokinase or a placebo daily. So did it work? So here we see on these graphs that systolic blood pressure dropped from originally 145 down to 131, while diastolic blood pressure dropped from 95 down to 89. Also notice that the blood pressure in the placebo takers also declined as well. That is the power of the placebo effect. However, the nattokinase blood pressure lowering effect in this study was deemed to be superior to that of the placebos. Now let's take a look at this clinical trial where they're investigating a specific brand of a nattokinase supplement. Here we're looking at 61 men and women, they're in their 50s, who had previously had a stroke. They're given nattokinase at a dosage of 1,200 fibrinolytic units in addition to conventional treatment, or that same conventional treatment with a placebo. And they do this daily for 2 months. The good news, people doing nattokinase appear to do better on stroke recovery tests. However, in terms of blood pressure lowering effect, nattokinase did not lower blood pressure better than a placebo. And speaking of proprietary supplements, here's another study where the researchers were investigating a supplement called Flite Tabs, which contained a combination of nattokinase and pycnogenol, which is an extract of pine bark. 204 men and women at risk of developing deep vein thrombosis are given 300 milligrams of these Flite Tabs before and 7 to 8 hours after a long airline flight. Results showed no DVTs, zero, in those who were taking the nattokinase pycnogenol supplement. However, there were 5 DVTs in those who were not taking it. Additionally, those who were not taking the supplement, they had about a 12% increase in edema. However, those who were taking the supplement had about a 15% reduction in edema. These results, pretty darn interesting. I do want to point out, however, because we are combining the nattokinase with pycnogenol, this study cannot tell us how much of an effect was contributed to by the nattokinase by itself. And that brings us to this study, which really made people sit up and take notice. 1,062 men and women in their 60s are followed for an entire year, and they're given nattokinase at 2 different dosages, a whopping 10,000 fibrinolytic units per day, or a lower dose at 3,600 fibrinolytic units. Now, the first thing that's reported here is that the lower dose of nattokinase didn't do a darn thing. However, at the higher dose, results were seen. For example, nattokinase promoted about a 22% reduction in carotid artery wall thickness and about a 36% reduction in the size of the plaques inside the carotid arteries. That alone is really impressive. The higher dose of nattokinase also was reported to lower cholesterol, LDL, and triglycerides too. Here's the before and after results for cholesterol, triglycerides, etc. And one of the things I don't like about this study is that they're reporting the results in nanomoles per liter, which for 99% of the people watching this video is utterly useless because your blood tests don't usually measure it in those units. So let's convert these units to more meaningful milligrams per deciliter. And if we do this, we can see that triglycerides drop from 164 down to 138. Total cholesterol goes down from 218 down to 183. This means that based on normal guidelines, the triglycerides and the total cholesterol levels were normalized. However, in terms of LDL cholesterol, that's a different story. These people dropped from 138 down to 113. That's good. However, they would still red flag on a blood test as being high for LDL. Additionally, these researchers are also reporting that nattokinase appeared to work better at lowering blood lipid levels when it's combined with either low-dose aspirin or vitamin K2. So overall, pretty impressive results. I do have one problem with the study, and that is this. It's not a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial. That's the very best kind of study to do. Essentially, what they did was they gave people nattokinase for a period of time, but then they compared those results to what people were in the past prior to the time this study was even performed. That's not the same thing as giving people nattokinase and a placebo, following them for a period of time and comparing the results. I also noticed they didn't seem to test blood pressure either, which is odd because measuring blood pressure is a pretty easy thing to do. Okay, let's try to make some sense of all this. Here are all of the human clinical trials on nattokinase that I was able to locate, and I know there is an awful lot going on with this table, so let's break it down and see what we can make of it. Number one, can nattokinase improve carotid artery health and carotid artery stiffness? I located one study showing nattokinase had no effect on carotid artery wall thickness or stiffness, and two clinical trials that showed just the opposite. One possibility for this disparity could be that those studies showing improvements did use higher amounts of nattokinase. Also, let's remember that of these studies, the one that used the highest amount, 10,000 FUs, was not a randomized placebo-controlled trial, which to me says, based on these studies, I think the question of whether nattokinase improves carotid artery stiffness and the thickness of the walls of the carotid artery is a little murky right now. Number two, can nattokinase lower blood pressure? Of the four studies I located on this, three of them used nattokinase at a dosage of 2,000 fibrinolytic units and found no significant changes in blood pressure. Whether higher amounts of nattokinase might have a different effect, I think that's open to speculation. Number three, does nattokinase lower cholesterol, LDL, triglycerides, etc.? I located five studies where blood lipids were mentioned. One of those clinical trials revealed nattokinase significantly lowered total cholesterol, but the other studies showed no effect even at higher doses. As you can see, the standout trial is this study involving over 1,000 people, which revealed significant reductions in cholesterol. But again, this is not a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled trial. So what about nattokinase combined with other supplements? I found three clinical trials where nattokinase was combined with either red yeast rice or pycnogenol, revealing a potential synergistic effect, but I think it's too soon to tell. And then the $64,000 question is, what about nattokinase as a potential natural clot buster? I located four clinical trials revealing that nattokinase appears to reduce blood clots and markers of blood clot formation, such as fibrin and fibrinogen. Potentially, this may indicate a real effect, but keep in mind, researchers tend to recruit generally healthy people for their clinical trials. To me, this says we don't yet know how well or if nattokinase works in people who are not so healthy. The good news is that none of the clinical trials I found revealed any significant side effects. That said, I still think it's a good idea to run nattokinase supplements past your doctor and pharmacist, especially if you take any medications, including blood thinners. I can see why so many people have asked me about nattokinase, because I am genuinely intrigued by the research I have seen so far. That said, I want to see larger clinical trials, especially in people who are not so healthy, before we can figure out if nattokinase really is everything it's cracked up to be.